Hi, all my friends, and welcome to another edition of Mrs. Goodfriend's Story Hour. Today, I'm out in my garden, my favorite place to read. And I realized it was kind of chilly, so I went inside to get my overcoat. Let me show you what my overcoat looks like. So this is my overcoat. My overcoat is very long, and it's very soft. It's made up of material that comes from a sheep's wool. Yeah, sheep's wool. And they spun it into thread, and then they weaved it and made this beautiful coat. And this is called an overcoat. It's a fancy coat. And I wouldn't usually wear it in my garden, but I was cold, so I put it on. I would usually wear this coat if I was going to a fancy birthday party, or maybe to a ball to go dancing like a princess. So it's a special dress-up coat. But today I decided to wear it because it was so soft and so warm. Okay. So, and by the way, today our story is about an overcoat. Let me tell you more about it. So in this story, a man named Joseph has this wonderful overcoat and he wears it for many, 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 many years, until it gets old and worn. That means that it starts to get all kinds of holes in it, and it stretches out. And let me show you, this is what it looks like when it gets old and worn. See, these are my shorts, and look what happened to them. They got old and worn. I had them for a very long time. See how they're all, there's Mr. Goodfriend. Hello, Mr. Goodfriend. See how they're all worn? And look, sometimes they get ripped. Do you see how they're ripped? Yeah. So when they get old and worn, you kind of can't wear them anymore. But in this story, Joseph decided he liked his overcoat so much that he didn't want to just throw it away. He thought maybe he could reuse it again. And that's just what he did. So we're going to read and find out what Joseph did with his overcoat. Let's take a look at the book. Let's look at the cover. Here's our cover. Here he is. This is Joseph, and this is his overcoat. But look, it has lots of holes in it, doesn't it? Lots and lots of holes. That means it's worn. I don't know if Joseph can wear it like that anymore. Do you think it'll keep him warm like that? I'm not so sure. Let's see what else we can find on this cover. Look, there's the title. Look, I know that because there's lots of words. Let's read and find out what the title says. Joseph had a little overcoat. And the author is Sims Taback. And I want to tell you something about this author. This story that Mr. Taback wrote is based on a song that he used to sing when he was a little boy. And he loved the song so much that he decided to put it in a book for us to be able to read. Isn't that cool? So let's read and find out what Joseph, our character in the story, does with his old and worn overcoat. Are you ready? Okay, let's open the book and see. Joseph had a little overcoat. It was old and worn. Oh my goodness, look. Do you see? There's Joseph. And look, look at the bottom of his overcoat. It has all these patches on it. Oh my goodness, that means it's very old. I don't know if Joseph can wear it like that anymore. Let's turn the page and see what you think is gonna happen to it. Hey, and look at this. Look, there's a hole. Can you see that? There's a hole in the book. Isn't that clever? Mr. Taback, who did the illustrations, thought it would be really cool to have a hole in the book to show what old and worn is like, I guess. Oh my goodness, look, there he is again, Joseph. Did his overcoat change? It looks like to me it changed too. It got shorter. Let's see what it says. So he made a jacket out of it and went to the fair. There he goes, off to the fair. Do you see? Now it's nice and short. It's called a jacket. What do you think he's gonna do next? Do you think the jacket's gonna stay, or do you think it's gonna get old and worn again? I think you're right. It might get old and worn because fabric wears out. Did you know that? Yeah, fabric on our clothes can wear out. Let's see what happens. Joseph had a little jacket and it got old and worn. We were right. Look, there's Joseph with his old worn jacket. Look, there's all his patches. You know, it's, and look, it's all tattered. That's called tattered on the bottom when it gets all kind of ripped up like that. Yeah. Let's see what he turns it into next. Oh, look, can you see it? There's a hole. Look what happens when we turn the page. Oh my goodness, it shows you what he turns it into. Do you know what he turned it into? Can you guess? Let's read and find out. So he made a vest out of it and danced at his nephew's wedding. Oh, look, he's having a good time with that vest on, dancing at his nephew's wedding. Isn't that cool? So now it's not a jacket anymore. It's a little vest that just kind of covers his belly. That's pretty cool, isn't it? What do you think he's gonna do next? Do you think he's gonna throw it away and say, nah, it's too old and worn, I don't wanna wear it anymore? Or do you think he's gonna think of another way to use it? I agree, thumbs up. I think he's gonna figure out another way to use it. Let's turn the page right now. Joseph had a little vest. It got old and worn. Oh, there's his little vest. Old and worn, remember? He's got the patches on it, and it's kind of getting all ripped up on the bottom. It's getting tattered. Oh, my. Let's see what happens. Oh, look, he's got some friends looking in to see what's going to happen. Look, when we turn the page, there's those holes again. Let's see what he turns it into. Oh, do you know what he turned it into? Do you know what that is? You're right. It's a scarf. Let's read and see if we're right. So he made a scarf out of it and sang in the men's chorus. The chorus is like a collection of men who get together and like to sing together special songs like we sing at school. Like when we sing our snake song or we sing our hello song. That's what that's like. Doesn't he look like he's pretty happy? Because he still has his special overcoat that he changed into something new. What do you think's gonna happen next? Do you think it's gonna be all done? Or do you think he's gonna change that scarf into something else because it gets old and worn? What do you think he's gonna, you think he's gonna change it into something else? What do you think he might change it into? Let me hear what you say. Oh, that's a good idea. Oh yeah, maybe he's gonna do that too. Let's read and find out. Joseph had a little scarf. It got old and worn. Oh, do you see it? There's the little scarf right up there. He's got it around his neck, but you see all the patches on it? That means it's getting old and worn and there's some holes in it too. What do you think Joseph's going to do? Oh, that's a great idea. Maybe he's going to turn it into something new. Let's find out. There's a hole again. Wow. Look now, guys. What did Joseph turn it into? Can you see? You're right. He turned it into a tie. Does your daddy sometimes wear a tie? Or your mommy sometimes wear a tie? Maybe when they go to work? That's a special kind of clothes that we wear when we get dressed up. Yeah. And some men that go to work that are called executives, they wear those too. Let's read and find out what he did. So he made a necktie out of his scarf and went to visit his married sister in the city. Oh, look at that. He looks like he's having a good time in the city with his sister, doesn't he? And that tie looks stunning. Let's see what's going to happen next. Joseph had a little necktie. It got old and, can you help me with the word? Worn. Very good. There it is. Old and worn. There's the patches and the hole. How do you think Joseph's feeling about that? I think he's a little sad and disappointed that it's getting worn too. Do you think he's just gonna throw it out? Or do you think he's gonna turn it into something new? I agree. I think he is going to turn it into something new. Let's read and find out. Oh, look, there's a little hole again. Oh, my goodness. Can you see? It's very small. I don't know what it is. Do you? Do you know what it is? Let's read and find out. So he made a handkerchief out of it and drank a glass of hot tea with lemon. So a handkerchief is like a tissue. You know when we use a tissue to blow our nose? Well, this is a handkerchief, but he's wearing it around his neck to keep his neck warm. And some people use a handkerchief to blow their nose. It's called a handkerchief. Yes. Oh, he looks so happy with his handkerchief, doesn't he? Yeah. Let's see what happens next. Oh, there he is in bed. It says, Joseph had a little handkerchief. It got old and worn, do you see? He's using it to blow his nose. Looks like he has maybe a little cold. Yeah, but it's, see, it's got the patch on it. It's got a hole in it. It's getting old and worn. Call it shabby. I wonder what Joseph's going to do. What do you think he's going to do? You think it's too small to do anything else with? Yeah. Oh, you think he might invent something new? Let's read and find out. Those are great predictions. Joseph had a little handkerchief that got old and worn, so he made a button out of it. Look at that. And used it to fasten his suspenders. These are called suspenders. Look at that. He made a button out of it. Did you know you could make a button out of fabric? I did not know that. Joseph is very clever, isn't he? He really uses his imagination. That's important to do. Here, let's take a closer look. Look at that. Pretty cool. Now that's very, very tiny, isn't it? Do you think he's going to be able to make anything else out of that little piece of fabric that he turned into a button? I don't know. Those are all good predictions. Let's turn the page and find out. Joseph had a little button. One day, he lost it. Oh no, you see? He's looking all around to see if he can find that button. I don't think he can find it. Oh, how do you think that's making Joseph feel? Sad, yes. I wonder what he's going to do to solve this problem. What would you do? Those are great ideas. Let's read and see what Joseph does. Now, he had nothing, right? He had nothing. So he looks kind of sad, doesn't he? So Joseph made a book about it, which shows you can always make something out of nothing. Look what Joseph did. He took all his memories of what he did with that overcoat, and he drew pictures and words to go with it. And he turned his adventure with his overcoat into a book so that others could share it too. Isn't that neat? I really like that story. Look at all the buttons. Isn't that neat? All those different kinds of buttons. They're round. There's big round ones and tiny little round ones in all different colors. Yeah. So maybe today you could find something that you could turn into something else and reuse it, just like Joseph did. Maybe there's something that you have that's broken that you were thinking about getting rid of, but you can use your imagination and turn it into something new. Wouldn't that be exciting? And Mrs. Goodfriend would love to see pictures of what you come up with. So I hope you enjoyed our story today, and I'll see you again next time for another version of Mrs. Goodfriend's Story Hour. Bye for now.